The nurse wakes me up at 5. I'll think of what I want to write, learn it by heart. You should come about 8. I'll dictate what I have.
Fine. I'll do my best.
Oh, I'm sure you will. Can we start tomorrow?
Of course.
See you later.
E S A R A. E S A O O. E S A R U U. Through, 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 through the.
Through the frayed curtains, a wan glow announces the break of day. My heel hurts. My head weighs a ton. A sort of diving bell holds my body prisoner. My main task now is to compose these bedridden travel notes from a castaway on the shores of loneliness. In the beginning, this naval hospital was founded to care for children with tuberculosis. In the main hall of the hospital, there is a white marble bust to the glory of Empress Eugenie, wife of Napoleon III, and the hospital's patroness. She visited often. There was a fat farm, a school, and a place where, so legend has it, the great Diaghilev rehearsed his ballet russe. They say it was here that Nijinsky made his famous leap, 12 feet in the air. No one here leaps in the air now. These days, there's only the elderly, enfeebled, or like me, rigid and mute. A battalion of cripples. I'm often wheeled to the place I call Cinecittà, a perpetually deserted terrace, looking out onto a landscape heavy with the poetic and offbeat charm of a movie set. At the foot of the sand dune, a handful of buildings like a ghost town in a western. I like to see the outskirts of Berck. They look like a set for model train. As for the sea itself, the foam is so white, it looks like it came out of special effects. But my favorite is the lighthouse, tall and robust, reassuring with its red and white stripes. I position myself under the protection of that brotherly symbol, guardian of sailors, but also of the sick, whom fate has cast to the very edge of life.